If you're like me, the first time someone tried to explain transformation of functions to you, you went completely cross-eyed. Maybe you've seen this before and it made perfect sense, in which case I have no idea why you're watching this, but maybe it made absolutely no sense. I know the first 97 times someone tried to explain it to me, I just looked at them cross-eyed. So hopefully this will provide you with a little bit of additional help to get through this transformation of function stuff and kind of why we do it. The problem with transformation of functions is that a lot of the applications for it are things like random number generators and bell curves and things like that. And by the time you actually explain the reason why you want to do it, everybody doesn't care anymore. They just want to get out of class. So, if nothing else, for the moment, just assume that these are actually important. If you become a scientist, you need to know how to do these things at some level. And that's what we're doing here today. So, the first thing you're going to look at is the vertical shifts. So, if you have a function and you add a number to it. So if you see up in the right corner, it says f of x plus k. So you have something, some kind of a function like a box. And a box can be a function. Well, it's not really a function, but it's a shape. Anyway, you have this shape and you're going to add plus k to it. Now the plus k takes you up. So if I had f of x plus 3 and f of x is my box, if I have box plus 3, that means I'm going to take my box and shift it up 3. Boop, boop, boop. So same thing goes for a minus sign. If I have box minus 3, it means take my box and go down 3, like that. Not too bad, right? One thing that's really important to remember about any kind of transformation is that anything that's outside the parentheses, like this plus 3, it's outside that x, it's not inside the x. That's stuff that has to do with up and down. Anything you see that's inside the parentheses is going to be side to side, so outside the parentheses, up and down. So let's look at another example. So here we got a triangle. If I have triangle plus 2, I go up 2. Now I just put that little dot in the corner of the triangle so you can kind of see an eye and keep an eye on where that dot goes. So that dot's going to go up 1, 2, and there it goes. So that's triangle plus 2. You could also have triangle minus 2, and it would go down 2. Do, 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 do. And these are fun. These are great because they're pretty intuitive, and all you have to do is move something. And as we'll see later, that would be a blessing if that's all we ever had to do. All right, so horizontal shifts. If you look up in the right corner, you see this is f of x minus h, and there's a specific reason we have that funky notation. But anything that's inside the parentheses, like we said, is going side to side, left and right. Now, this is a little counterintuitive, and this is what starts to make things fun. This is just a preview of how exciting this is going to get. So you had f of x minus 3, and the x minus 3 is in that parenthesis. That means we go left to right, but x minus 3 actually goes to the right. Even though it's a minus sign, I know you think minus signs would go left, but they don't. Minus signs go right. Go right 3. So again, you can see that center dot goes to the right 3 and brings everything with it. Now, f of x plus 3 goes, you got it, to the left. Do, 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 do. Now, see, isn't that perfect? Isn't that exactly what you would expect it to do? Yeah, it's not. And that's why everybody wants to tear their hair out when they do these things. Let's try something else. We got our little triangle. Again, f of x minus 3 means going 3 to the right. Do, 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 do. 3 to the right. And we could take, similarly, f of x plus 3 in the parentheses, left to right. Do, 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 do. And there she goes. All right. What's fun is when you combine these. This is important to remember. We're going to use it whenever we add even more different kinds of transformations. But anytime you do any transformation, the left-right shift is always first, and the up-down shift is always last. So if you've got a left-right, you do it first. If you have an up-down, you do it last. And any other transformation you learn is going to go somewhere in between. So if we add something like f of x minus 1 plus 3, we say, okay, the minus 1 we're going to do first because it's inside the parenthesis. And minus 1 means we go to the right, 1 unit. The plus 3 on the end means we go which direction? It's up or down. Plus 3 takes us up. Okay, so we're going to take our triangle, first of all, and do to the right 1 shift. And we go do 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 do. And then we need to go up 3. And there we go. Was that 3? It always looks like more than 3, but that's just 3. So your final transformation is going to always be, whenever we're doing these, the pink shape, because I like pink. All right, So let's try this one. Same triangle again. F of x plus 4 plus 2. The left-right shift is on the inside of the parentheses. That's the one we're going to do first. And we think, okay, plus 4 means we go left or right. Which one? It's going to be left. This is the backwards one. Plus 4 goes to the left. So we're going to do that one first. Then we're going to do the plus 2 on the end. That's our up-down shift. And since it's plus 2, we go up. So we'll do this one. To the left, 4. And then we're going to go up 2. And again, the pink triangle is our final position for our shape. We'll try one more with our square. We have f of x plus 4 minus 1. We always work from the inside of the parentheses outward. So we start inside the parentheses. That's a left-right shift. Plus 4 means we go which direction? Again, it's still to the left. And the minus 1 on the end is our up-down shift. And since it's minus, we go down. So take our square, go to the left 4, and we're going to go down 1. And it's okay that they overlap, but we just know that the pink one is our final transformation position.